Back when Reggie retired from his position at Nintendo in 2019, he shared this photo online on his brand spanking new Twitter account. And some eagle-eyed office chair aficionados noticed that Reggie had been sitting his readied body in an outdated 12-year-old office chair, a Herman Miller Mira 1. Which, by the way, we have to say, that's still an expensive quality chair from what we've heard. It's not like he was sitting in a hand-me-down from his pops, you know, like the generic kind that you find at a department store that's made of black leather that eventually, it's fake black leather, by the way, and it eventually just peels off and looks like trash. But the thing is Herman Miller doesn't even produce the Mira 1 anymore, and Nintendo fans thought that Reggie deserved better. So thanks to Jason Cryer and 23,000 fans who signed a change.org petition, it caught the attention of Herman Miller, and they sent Reggie a fully loaded Aeron chair of his own. Which, for anyone unaware, it's basically the Rolls-Royce, the wee gold-plated system, the holy grail of office chairs. And just like that, that chapter of the internet was closed. And thanks to this photo that Reggie shared on his Twitter during the Game Awards, we can see that Reggie is still happily using it. So why exactly are we bringing this back up, you say? Well, because I too now have a Herman Miller chair of my own. Not an Aeron, not a Mira, but something new. I'm Zian from Nintendo Life, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Herman Miller X Logitech G Embody Gaming Chair. That is a mouthful. In 2020, Herman Miller launched a new partnership with Logitech to create a chair designed specifically for gamers, as you'd expect, a gaming chair. But they wanted to do something different. They wanted to make a chair that would support you while you play, something that you feel comfortable in, and we were fortunate enough to get our hands on one. This is a modified version of the Herman Miller Embody chair with input from Logitech, with adjustments made to keep you comfy during long gameplay sessions. But is this chair really worth the high asking price? What's up with the Dead Space looking spine? So let's go ahead and check this out. The Embody boasts most of your standard office chair features, a joystick style lever for seat height, a tilt limiter that lets the seat lean back, and adjustable arms that go up, down, and even in and out. But one of the main features of this throne is a lever which adjusts what Herman Miller is calling posture fit spinal support. It contours the back of the chair to the unique shape of your spine to give you the perfect amount of support wherever your back needs it. And while a few parts are made of plastic, like the arms and the blue backing on the chair, the majority is made of high quality materials. The seat itself is made of a durable polyester material with a layer of foam underneath to help keep you cool and evenly distribute heat. And instead of sitting on a plank of wood, which I'm pretty sure was underneath the cushion of my last seat, your bottom is actually being supported by a springy labyrinth of cords that gives your bottom a bit of bounce when you sit down. And while the cushion is thicker than the mesh of an Aeron chair, it's still much more breathable than your typical gaming chair. The Embody also has quite a bit of heft to it, so if you decide to lean back every now and again, you shouldn't have to worry about tipping over, which was actually a major concern for me with my last chair. Not saying that I ever did fall over, but... And if you're the kind of person that needs a bit more room or likes to sit in different positions, the seat itself can actually be extended outward to better support your legs. And unlike most gaming chairs on the market, the Embody also ships fully assembled, so you don't have to stress about putting it together wrong as it easily rolls just straight out of the box. Felix the Cat, however, is not included. Herman Miller has been in the business of making chairs since 1905, so why did they suddenly decide to get in the business of making chairs for gamers now? Why make a gaming chair when there's a wealth of competition already out there? So we decided to sit down digitally with John Campbell, director of the gaming division at Herman Miller, and he had this to say.
I think a lot of people, you know, there's a monumental moment in their life where it kind of is a defining moment that kind of sets them on a certain path. And that one, that moment for me was this conversation that I had with, he was a pro player. When I was talking with this player, he was turning 24 in a week when I was talking to him. And hearing his anxiety about turning 24 just baffled me. And, you know, I talked more about that, or I asked him more about it. I was like, well, what about turning 24 is so like detrimental to your career? And he's like, well, it's my neck is hurting, my arm is hurting, my shoulder is hurting, my back is hurting. He's like, even after, you know, 4 hours of practicing, I have to go and lay down for 4 hours because my body is just hurting all over. And that was this moment for me, because everything that we do on the office side from our task chairs is about, it's about health and well-being and keeping people healthy, right? If you're going to sit for a quarter of your life, you might as well be sitting in something that's going to support you and keep you healthy doing everything else that you want to do. And this was that moment of like, holy smokes, like we're not here to build, you know, a cool looking, you know, thing that people get excited about. We're here to improve the health of the gaming industry, you know, physical health, mental health, societal health, a bunch of, you know, we could define that in a bunch of different areas. But that was that point in time that kind of set us on this path that like, we're here to do something completely different and much bigger than what pretty much any other organization's doing within the gaming chair space right now.
The Embody gaming chair has a cool futuristic look to it, a chair that would fit right in the world of Dead Space. But that style is actually a byproduct of Herman Miller putting functionality first and foremost.
Where are the cup holders? There's no long leg rest, and there's not even a branded pillow for when I want to take a nap.
Every single component of the chair is designed for a very specific reason, and that reason is to support the human body. And if there's a part of the chair that doesn't support the human body and doesn't actually serve that purpose, then it's eliminated from the chair. So that's why what you have on this chair is you don't have a giant billboard with a logo, you know, smeared all over it, because that's not there to support the human form. We're not out there in a way of like creating these billboards or advertisement using the chair. The chair is not intended to do that. The chair is actually intended to support the player and improve their health. And that's what Herman Miller is here to do too.
Before Herman Miller sent over the Embody gaming chair for us to check out, I had been using a fairly gross and fairly old office chair that I picked up from a local thrift shop. Now, it was a considerable upgrade over what I was using before, but considering the amount of time I spend sitting in a chair for work or even just in my free time, editing videos, playing games at my desk, my back was not happy. No matter how I sat, I'd usually end up with some new pain in my back. Now, I've been using the Embody gaming chair for probably about 2 months now at 40 hours a week. And granted, I did just get a brand new bed about 3 or 4 months ago. I haven't felt any considerable pains in my back, even pinches, in a long time. It's something I don't even think about anymore. And this isn't a sponsorship. This is not paid for. Herman Miller gave us this chair to do the review, but if this chair sucked, trust us, we would tell you.
The way the chair contours to your back is a thing of beauty, and it's extremely easy to make micro adjustments whenever you want or need to change things up. And as we mentioned before, the ability to extend or decrease the front of the seat is a really nice touch as well. Anyone who's familiar with Herman Miller's products will know of their high asking price, and the Herman Miller X Logitech G Embody gaming chair is really no different, retailing for a whopping $1,495. That amount of money could net you a ton of cool things, like a down payment on a car, a Nintendo Switch with 20 fully priced games, or even a PlayStation 5 and some games on the black market. However, much like a mattress or even a car, a chair like this can be looked at as an investment, one that you could get a lot of mileage out of, especially these days. But this also isn't a purchase that every gamer can make, especially in this climate. So really, it'll come down to your own situation to determine the worth of the Embody gaming chair. From the chat we had with John, it seems like the Herman Miller X Logitech G Embody gaming chair seems like it's more targeted at the professional gamer and streamer. But there's no denying the fact that this may be one of the best gaming chairs money can buy. And Herman Miller's passion to keep our backs healthy is appreciated and evident, especially in an age where we're doing a lot more sitting at home than we used to. Now, at the time of recording, the Embody is currently the only gaming chair in Herman Miller's lineup. But when asked if we could possibly see a more widely affordable range down the road, John simply said,
"Yes, absolutely. Is all I will give you at the moment, but yes."
Okay. That's great to hear. That's something. Yeah.
And before we let John go, since we had him on the line, we had to ask him one more question.
I think that's pretty much all of the questions I have about the chair itself. I did want to touch on Reggie a little bit as well, just for fun.
It was so exciting. It was actually one of our data points that we used internally as we start to look to the gaming industry, is like, look how exciting, look at how this audience gets so excited about, you know, about a chair. The story there was just so interesting because it, you know, like he was sitting on a mirror chair for quite some time. The community was just up in arms that he didn't have the throne of all chairs, right? The Aeron right. chair. It was so much fun to like be having that team reach out to Reggie and to, you know, talk to him about, you know, what are his specific needs. And this is, I mean, at the core of what we do is we try to best support people and help them find the right chair. And that was, I think, a great opportunity for us to kind of interject Herman Miller into this space in a way that I think is really important, which is about contributing to the community. And that was a really, I think, an important moment for Herman Miller to partake in. We just want to add value to this industry. And we were able to do that by partaking in the Chairgate scandal that just wreaked havoc on the gaming industry.
We'd like to send a huge thank you out to Herman Miller for sending us this chair and even just for taking the time to sit down and chat with us. Feel free to let us know in the comments down below what you think of the Embody gaming chair, and be sure to let us know if any of you have actually sat on this, if one of you have this yourself as well. Let us know what you think. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more content like this, then why don't you go ahead and straighten out the back of that subscribe button and then ring that notification bell to be notified whenever we release new videos. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm ZM from Nintendo Life. Stay safe out there, and we will see you next time. Is this what a gamer chair is supposed to be like?